back to my channel. Welcome to this video, which is a home bargains haul. I've done that thing that I always forget, and I've sat opposite the window with the light shining on my glasses, and I can't be bothered to move. So I'm afraid you'll have to put up with that reflection and me trying to, every now and again I'll go like this to try and get the reflection to go. Like, over here. Or down here. No, that doesn't work. Maybe there. That doesn't do much for the chins. Anyway, it's a home bargains haul, and it's nothing very unusual for me. I buy pretty much the same stuff most of the time. There's a couple of bits that I don't usually buy, but as I haven't done a home bargains haul video for a while, I thought I would show you what I've got. So let's start with some very, very run-of-the-mill ordinary stuff. I got some onions. Three red onions in home bargains is 59p. Three red onions in Tesco yesterday, they wanted 129, and I thought that was a lot of money for three red onions. 59p red onions, just for salads and or cooking. I got a washing machine cleaner because our washing machine smells again. I have talked to you guys about this in home bargains haul videos before, about the fact that our washing machine smells. I always leave the door open. I clean it out between uses. I've stopped using the little tabs, and now I use the liquid because somebody said they found that helped. I don't know why our washing machine smells. I don't know if it's a problem perhaps with the way it's plumbed in. Obviously it's plumbed into the bit under the sink. Maybe there's some kind of feedback going on there. I don't know. Anyway, I got a washing machine cleaner to give it a bit of a run through and see if I can improve it a bit. The Dettol antibacterial lemon washing machine cleaner is £2.99. 5-in-1, it says kills bacteria, prevents bad odours, removes limescale, removes hidden dirt, and gives you lasting freshness. So let's hope it does. I bought some floor wipes. These were really, really cheap. I thought they were 79p, and I thought that was a really good price. I've certainly paid... Hello, Kai. Kai's come to have a look at the floor wipes. I've certainly paid more than 79p for floor wipes before. And with three dogs, we go through them like you wouldn't believe. So apparently they kill off MRSA, Salmonella and E. coli, which implies that you can eat your dinner off the floor afterwards. I don't think we will be. Those are also lemon flavour. They're citrus burst. Citrus burst. I bought this for Mum. Mum has been experiencing headaches recently. Not entirely sure why. But recently, probably a couple of times a week when I speak to her, she's like, oh, I've got a headache. So I spotted these. They are cooling gel sheets for migraines. Cool and soothe. And they give you 8 hours continuous cooling. They're non-medicinal. There's 4 in the pack, I think it said. Yeah. It says, cool and soothe migraine is designed to provide immediate cooling relief to the severe discomfort associated with migraine and headaches. Comforting and soothing, they provide a gentle cooling, continuous cooling effect for up to 8 hours, helping you through your migraine. Non-medicinal, safe to use with medication, directions for use, cut open, remove one gel sheet, remove the transparent film, wipe away sweat from skin before using. Place the gel sheet to the forehead or the back of the neck, and you can cut it up if you want to. They were £1.99 for 4, and I thought it was worth a go. She might not use them because she's a little bit unsure of anything new, so she might think they're... My mum honestly might think that those are a bit too technical for her, but she might use them, and if she doesn't, I'll have them back at some point and use them myself, which is what happens with a lot of things that I get her that I think will be helpful. She goes, well, no, I wasn't sure about that. I treated myself to 2 Reese's Christmas trees, and I think this indicates how much I have grown as a person, because I bought just this pack. And certainly the old me would have bought 10 packs, because these are my favourite things in the whole wide world. The old me would have bought 10 packets of those and probably eaten them within about 3 or 4 days. So I feel like that shows my evolving into a less greedy bastard. They are 79p, I think. No, they're not, the 99p for the 2 in there. I got myself some Saint coconut and chocolate bars. I really like these. They're 97 calories each. And they are 99p for a pack of 5. They taste like a proper nice treat. It has been said several times on my diet videos, people are saying, you know, you need to stop buying the snacks. Don't have the snacks in the house. I know how I operate. If there's nothing in the house that I can have for a treat, I will go to the shop and I will buy a stack of stuff. Because when I get there, I'll fancy all of it. I'll get there and I'm like, oh, I like Bakewells and I like this and I like this. So I'll buy all of it. And then when I get home, I will eat more of it than I intended to, rather than just having the little snacks in the house. So I know what works for me. The trick is not to have several different snacks. I bought a packet of scented petal bin liners. These are for my bedroom bin. And I'm going to give you a little trick here that you can take... It's just bin liners. This dog. Just bin liners. Lemon scented as well. You won't even like them. Little trick that you can take home and use. Gratis, free of charge, on me. Do not remove your bin liner from the roll. Drop the roll into your bin. Attach your bin liner as usual over the top of the bin. When it's time to replace it, you just pull it up and the next one is already there, instead of you having to remember to go and find a new bin liner. You can take that one free of charge. I'll give you that. You're welcome. It's just bin liners. Kaiki's got a toy, which I think he possibly wants back. I took it off so I could film, bless him. Molly's got one as well. Molly's got a little brown hedgehog one. Kaiki's got a turtle. They're called space balls, and he really liked them before, but they had a squeak before. I think he can't find the squeak in this. I don't think it has one. There you go. Boink. Were they on my bill or Natalie's bill? They were £1.99 each. I got the dogs a packet of Schmackos, but I seem to have lost them. There we go. A packet of Schmackos treats. Buddy is quite happily waiting for, aren't you, mate? I got them the multi-pack of flavours, so I think you get beef, lamb and poultry. Don't they sound delicious? They don't smell delicious. One for you. Good boy. Molly, would you like one? Come on then. Matthew Pie. Good boy. Those are 99p for the pack, I think. Oh no, those are exactly a pound. I got some more of these little Cathedral City nibbles. These are excellent for portion control on a diet. If I make a salad, I have one of these little packets on top, and they're tiny little cubes of cheese. They're made for lunch boxes, but it's a real good way of having a calorie controlled portion of cheese on a salad. Each bag is 53 calories. So yeah, really good way of having a portion controlled cheese topping for salad. It's Kai ripping the lavish toy. You okay? Molly's already taken the middle out of hers and now she's sitting on her bed guarding it in case Kai tries to take it. Oven liner. I haven't bought these before, but I've seen plenty of people using them on Instagram cleaning pages and stuff like that. The idea being that you clean your oven and then once you've put this in the base of your oven, you don't need to clean the base of your oven very often after that. It says liners should be wiped clean regularly, but these should be, you know, these should be easier to wipe than the actual bottom of your oven. Do not exceed an oven temperature of 260 centigrade, 500 F or gas mark 10. Who has an oven that goes up past gas mark 10? Anyway, this was £1.99, I believe. It was £1.99, and anything that means I'd clean the oven a bit less often, that's a win in my book. I got a big thing of the multivitamins. I took these all last winter. I think they helped. They're chewy and they don't taste bad, so that was good. And they're just multivitamin gummies. So they contain vitamin A, D3, E, C, niacin, B6, B12, pantothenic acid, biotin, zinc and iodine. Do I need iodine? Why do we need, what do we use iodine for? That's what they wash you with. You have an operation, isn't it? What do we need iodine in? And somebody out there will know. In the comments below, if you know why we need iodine in our bodies, in our multivitamins, don't Google. That'd be cheating. If I wanted to Google, I could do it myself. Okay, so they were £4.99. And you get 120. So bear in mind that some days I forget. They'll probably last me most of the winter. This little packet of ankle socks is for a sock project that I want to do. So some of you who have been around my channel for a while will know that I made a little sock lockdown buddies, and I'm going to make a little sock something else. So I thought these were nice prints. There's a pink leopard print, there's some with stars on, there's an ordinary leopard print and just a pink and grey one. So that's what they are for. They are children's socks and they were £2 for five. I hadn't seen these before. These are Papita. They're made by a company called Solen. There are 8 individual packets in there. 95 calories per 20 grams. So each one is 20 grams. That's 95 calories in there. And I hadn't seen them before and I thought I'd try them. They are kind of a biscuit bar with a caramel and milk topping. It says crispy biscuit with milk, chocolate and caramel filling decorated with colourful candy dragees, which is what you and I think of as Smarties. They look like that. Not very large, but then they wouldn't be for those calories. That's very nice. That's really nice. 95 calories. It's a nice treat. It's quite chewy, so you don't go through it too quickly. They were 89p for 8, so I think that's a really good price. Nice treat. These couple of bits are also on the table are nuts, and I don't know how much she paid for them because she paid separately and I haven't got her receipt. But she got some heat protection styling spray, some Malteser white truffles, which are our absolute favourite, and some Maltesers hot chocolate. But cannot tell you what she paid, don't know. I got some salt and vinegar pombears. I really like the salt and vinegar pombears. They are only 65 calories a packet, and I really, really like those. So they're 99p for a six pack. And just in case the kitchen sink is having the knock-on effect on the washing machine, I thought I'd give it a knock through with some plug hole unblocker. It's not actually blocked, but it's running a bit slow, so I'm thinking maybe these two things are connected. So I've got a Kill Block. Kill Block is the company, Kill Block is the product. Plug hole unblocker for kitchen and outdoor. It says blasts through blockages. That was £1.99. I bought a little candle. Now, I try not to buy candles. Oops, sorry, I'm leaning on the table. It's making the camera wobble. Try not to buy candles because I have quite a few candles upstairs that I never liked. I'm a terrible one for thinking that's a lovely scented candle I want, but I never like them. This one's gingerbread, and I thought, I do want my house to smell like gingerbread, I do. So I'm going to find one of Natalie's lighters in a minute and light it immediately, and then it probably won't last very long. It's only a mini one, and it was 59p, so it's not going to last very long, is it? I don't know how much burn time you're meant to get, but I shouldn't imagine it's much. It says don't burn for more than 4 hours at one time. I wouldn't have thought that had much more than 4 hours burn time in it anyway. There was a chocolate orange one, and I really wanted that, but they only had that in a larger size, and I knew that a larger size candle is a waste because I forget to burn them. So I just bought the little mini gingerbread one. The chocolate orange one was very nice. I think we're nearly done. I got, some cooking liners as well as the oven liner. I got some cooking liners. Our roasting trays are a bit past their best, if I'm honest, and it might be time to invest in new ones, but I thought cooking liners will. It won't help the kids because they won't remember to use them, because I mean, I've got a roll of greaseproof paper and I keep saying if you could just pop some of that down, that would make those roasting trays a lot easier to clean, but they never remember. But this is one of those reusable liners. So you just lay the sheet on the tray and hopefully they'll remember to use it. That was £1.99 as well, I think. Oh, I tell a lie, that was 79p. Absolute bargain. Not sure what accent that was meant to be. I got free range eggs. 6 free range eggs for 79p. Managed to get them home without breaking any of them. That's nothing short of a miracle. I bought some Onken 0% fat natural yoghurt to try and make pizza bases with. I keep seeing people on these slimming pages making pizza bases out of natural yoghurt and flour and nothing else. I thought I'd give it a go. That was 89p. It has a really long life on it. It lasts until the 15th of November, so there was no rush for me to make pizza bases. Next thing is the toys. Oh, I got some forks. Where are my forks? Literally, where are my forks is all I have been saying for about 3 weeks now. Where are all the forks? Why are there no forks in this house? Where have the forks gone? So rather than buy an entire new cutlery set, I've just bought 5 extra forks. And what will happen is at some point I will go into Natalie's room and I will have a mad blast tidy up because it is disgusting in there. And I will find all of the missing forks. These are not, I wouldn't want to eat with these. They're not comfortable to hold. If you buy cheap cutlery, it's not designed very well. It's not ergonomically designed to be comfortable in your hand. But these ones will be fine for dog food and stuff like that. And apparently there's 4. I thought there was 5. No, it says 4-pack and there is 4. So that was not a lie. And they were £1.29. £1.29 for 4 forks. 4 candles. No, just forks. I got some makeup remover wipes. They were £1.25 and I got the Johnson's 5-in-1 refreshing ones. These are the best in my opinion. And the last 2 items are some brown sugar, which Anthony prefers to have in his coffee. We don't use it for anything else, and yet frequently we seem to run out. And Anthony said to me, have we got any brown sugar? And I'm like, don't use it. Got more brown sugar. And last but by no means least, blasters. I fell out of the loft yesterday. Not quite as tragic as it sounds. Only one leg fell out of the loft. The other leg saved me, and boy do I know about it today. But on the way out of the loft, I knocked the top off my mosquito bite, and it bled and it bled and it bled and it bled. And I didn't have any plaster. So I ended up walking around with a wadge of toilet or sellotape to my leg to try to stop the bleeding. So I thought I'd invest in some plasters today. I don't know where all the plasters go, honestly. I spent a total of £34.39 in home bargains today, slightly more than my usual 30 quid roundabout spend, but I did get the multivitamins and they were a fiver on their own, so I think that accounts for it. I hope you've enjoyed this haul video. I bought a couple of things that I don't normally buy. I don't know whether this is interesting or not, but I hope you've enjoyed it regardless, and I'll be back soon. Take care. Bye for now.